Alright, yo, this is the long-awaited badge grind video I've got on my badges Hall of Fame. I'm gonna work on tireless score of gold, but that for me is no longer a priority. I'm testing jump shots again. I'm back on Prime, I'm having a little bit more fun. The badge grind is something serious. We're talking about the key badges for sharpshooters, corner specialists, deep range, dead eye, limitless range, and catch and shoot. I'm gonna start speaking on some general tips and then we'll dive into the specific badges to talk about how to get them fast. Skip games against lockdown defense. The amount of times I went up against Klay Thompson or Kawhi Leonard and just had an awful game is ridiculous. Those long, tall defenders will give you a torturous time with these shooting badges. Just remind yourself when you're hopping into a my career game, because my career is the best way to do this. If you know there's gonna be a lockdown defender on the other team, hit it with a juke and skip on to the next game. The percentages matter this year when you're grinding for badges. Last year, I could chuck up shots all day and go for deep range dead eye. This year, if I'm shooting 35%, it's gonna be a lost game. Most games, you wanna be shooting over 50% if possible, especially if you're a pure sharpshooter. There's no excuse you shoot under 50%. Pretty much on all of these badges, you're gonna wanna either put pressure defense, go for traps, or pretty much cherry pick. There's, especially when I was going for corner specialists, I'll speak on, I literally didn't even show up for defense. I just stood in the corner, and then when the other team bricked the shot, they would chuck it full court for me. So there's gonna be a lot of that. You wanna click square once, you click it twice, and they usually call a foul on me. So click it once, it doesn't work, just run back to the other end, get ready for offense. And last, before we hop into the individual badges themselves, play on pro difficulty. If you hop on the park, it will change your difficulty to online park sliders. You do not wanna be playing on those. It's more challenging than pro difficulty. Switch it back to pro every time you hop back on my career. Now I'm gonna be speaking specifically on my career a lot because that's basically where I did most of this, but you wanna switch it up because if you go on my career all the time, the amount you make starts to slowly dwindle. So every like 4 my career games, switch it up with a pro-am game and then go right back to my career. At no point would I recommend for these badges do you do them on the park. The only badge I've noticed gets done really well in the park is difficult shots. I got that on silver by accident. I wasn't even grinding for that one. All right, we're gonna get started on what for me initially seemed like the most challenging badge to get, but what became, with catch and shoot, the easiest badges to get for your sharpshooter, and that's limitless range. I wanna give a shout out to Snubby because I was tweeting out my frustrations. He hit me up and said, yo, Agent, you need to try this method. Basically, you wanna hold turbo and flick back on your right stick. I don't have pro dribble moves, I don't have elite dribble moves. You can do this with any player and you'll do step backs and it'll create room. And for whatever reason, the AI doesn't close that room. You can't use pick and rolls this year. They always hedge the pick and roll. They beat you to the point. I tried pick and pops. They work sometimes, but your garbage teammates never hit you when you're open. It is such a challenge to shoot from limitless, especially if you're not a pure sharpshooter, it's gonna be difficult. So you wanna get to the 3-point line, do a put step back, do another step back if you need more room, and then pull up for the shot. You'll get the room you need. At that point, it's just about releasing the ball correctly. And that's all there is to it. Literally, point blank period, once you start using this method, you can get 15,000, 20,000 a game on my career for limitless range. And in fact, limitless range is also a very easy one to get on Pro-Am as well, especially if you're a primary sharpshooter or a pure sharpshooter. Most of the shots I take are from limitless range because people always gonna keep an eye on you when you're a sharpshooter, especially a pure sharpshooter. They're gonna close you out, and so I use that limitless range to create some distance. So I'm not gonna dive too deep into this. I'll leave Snubby's link in the description, but show him some love because before I found out about this move, I was trying the whole thing, you know? I even tried, you know how you can do a step back, you can click back on the left stick and click square, and it'll do the weird little, it was, trust me, I tried it all, but that method right there is the only one I found to work. The next one is catch and shoot. There is no point in me explaining how to get catch and shoot. You will get that badge by accident. Do not ever do a workout to grind catch and shoot in the practice facility. Do not at any point focus your efforts on catch and shoot. It will just come. Catch and shoot has to be one of the easiest badges in the game to get. You just have to shoot a high percentage. If you're shooting a booty 20% from the 3-point, it's gonna take you pretty long to get Hall of Fame. So as long as you're shooting 40% plus, you're solid. All right, the next one is the most challenging one by far. Welcome, y'all. This is deep range dead eye we're talking about. Now, we're gonna spend an extensive time on this one because I will save you guys hours here in this video, hours upon hours upon hours. I tried all the methods, all right? I tried everything to try and make it work with this deep range that it was killing me. So again, my career is the best way to get this badge. But between my career games, you can head to the practice facility. Now, you guys should know about the practice facility already. You shouldn't need an explanation. There, you can do the deep range deadeye drill. You only need to hit 4 out of the 10 shots to get a 3-star. Every time you get a 3-star, you'll get 800 points towards deep range deadeye and 200 points towards catch and shoot. You do that 3 times. You leave the practice facility and go. There's a juice bar right outside the practice facility. When you go there, it'll give you a +1 practice. You go back into the practice facility, you do that last practice, and then you hop into a My Career game. So in total, between your My Career games, you should be going to 4 deep range deadeye practices, 800 apiece. Let me do some quick math. That's 3,200. Between every game, you should be getting 3,200 towards deep range deadeye. Between every game, every single game, you're gonna need those. Now, when it comes to deep range deadeye, once you finish the game, it actually tells you to get it, you have to shoot contested deep threes. But all throughout the time I was going for limitless range, I was shooting contested deep threes. It wasn't like I was being left open for those. So I was like, bro, how do you get this badge, man? But I realized, I said, yo, just forget deep range deadeye, I'll go for corner specialist. And when I started to go for corner specialist, I realized, bro, I'm starting to get deep range deadeye. The best way in my career to get deep range deadeye is to head to the corner, give yourself a little bit of room, do the same step backs you were doing for limitless range, but now you're doing it for deep range deadeye. Put up one pump fake and then go up for the shot. The one pump fake is essential to being able to get deep range deadeye. The shot feedback will be on the top right of the screen. You want that to say heavily contested. For whatever reason, if you do the step backs and go up for the shot immediately in the corner and it's lightly contested, there's gonna be a low percentage, especially if you're not a pure sharp, that you're gonna make the shot on pro difficulty. So make life easy upon yourself. When you take that one pump fake, for whatever reason, your percentage is skyrocket, especially if you get your opponent to jump. So when you're getting deep range deadeye, you also will be getting corner specialist. So it kind of goes hand in hand, but we'll talk about corner specialist later. 2 step backs, pump fake, go up. 2 step backs, pump fake, go up. And in between all of that, I like to still cherry pick and go for corner specialist, because if you end up getting hot, it'll make your time a lot easier. So I don't focus extensively only ever on deep range deadeye. I'll do like 3 possessions where I do, and then I'll switch it up. I might go for limitless range, even if I have Hall of Fame. Just getting some shots into the basket, especially if you've missed a few shots, because there'll be times where you just get clamped down, right? And you make sure your release is on point, because if your release is not on point and you're shooting those heavily contested shots, you're not getting deep range deadeye anytime soon. But there's also different methods to getting deep range deadeye. If you find yourself missing a lot on My Career, you're like, agent, like, I'm trying to do it in my career on pro difficulty, I'm doing that pump fake method, but it's not working. And this is likely if sharpshooter is your secondary archetype. So you might be rocking like a 76 open shot 3. It's gonna be challenging to do the method I just explained. For you, there's a 1-minute glitch, right? Thank God for the glitch. Hop into your practice facility, man. Go to options, change the timer to 5 minutes. Hop into your jump shot crater. Change your jump shot or keep it the same. Just move it around a little bit. Save and exit. Once you've saved and exit, go back to options. Go to the timer. It'll say 5 minutes. Click right, and it'll go to 1 minute. It's a simple glitch. A bunch of people uploaded videos on it. Basically, you wanna be setting your My Career to 1 minute. Once you do that, and I did this strategy as well, and it's a grind, but if you can't do it on My Career, it's like, you're playing all that time on My, and you still, so this is probably the next best way to do it, is you wanna just like let the game sit, be on your computer, do something else for the time, and then get those 3,200 points from those 4 practices at the practice facility. That's a method. It's a long ass method, especially if you're going for Hall of Fame. Imagine doing 3,200 a time, and you have to wait a game between all of that just to get deep range deadeye Hall of Fame. If you're going for gold or silver, this is a little bit more reasonable for you to do. And luckily for deep range deadeye, percentages don't matter. It'll say contested deep shots made, and it'll go times 7. It won't say 7 out of 40, so you can brick a whole ton and you can still get deep range deadeye with the same level of effectiveness. You're just potentially messing up your hotspots. I wanted to make sure my percentages were high because, one, I didn't want to waste every, like, I'm trying to be efficient with my time, but 2, I didn't want to ruin my hotspots on My Career, even though I'm hearing hotspots really aren't that important this year. And just one last tip for the drills when you're doing deep range deadeye, you can call for the ball before going up for the shot. I know for me, the first bunch of times I did it, every time I was making it a catch and shoot. And especially the one that's right at the top of the three-point line, call for the ball first, get it, and then just walk up and pull up for your shot. It makes life a lot easier. I don't even like doing catch and shoots like that. Literally, you only have to hit 4 out of 10, so you literally can't mess it up. All right, so that's that. That's Deep Range Deadeye. It's the biggest grind when it comes to these badges. Now is Corner Specialist. So as I mentioned, Corner Specialist is a pretty simple one to get. This was the last one I went for because it was a simple one to get. You literally, when I say cherry pick, I don't mean wait for the ball to go up and then sprint. I mean the whole possession on defense, you need to be playing offense. Literally, like the Sacramento Kings tried that a few years ago. It was a disaster. It works in 2K. For whatever reason, very good shooters will break shots sometimes. Like I was going up against, It was James Harden, and he just continued to brick. So I'm like, yo, why don't I just stand on offense in the corner? They'll chuck it to you. Sometimes it'll be a turnover. Sometimes they'll actually call you for the turnover because you'll catch it out of bounds. Do you care about your teammate grade? I'm hoping you don't, because it's gonna be tough to do it otherwise. And I'm saying is one of the corner specialists pretty simple because you can literally get 20,000 a game for corner specialists on 12-minute quarters. If you have catch and shoot, it's gonna help you on all of these, but it's gonna especially help you on corner specialists. I do the same method to get corner specialists I did to get deep range deadeye. I'll do the two step backs, and this, keep in mind, this is on a half court set. I'll do two step backs, pump fake, and then I'll go up for the shot. So I'll go up in deep range deadeye, and I'll go up in corner specialist. For me, that's a win-win. But if I have an opportunity open in the corner, I'm not gonna wait for a contest. I'm gonna try and get my percentages up, because for corner specialists, percentages matter. So if you're gonna shoot a booty 30%, you're not gonna get a good game, especially if you're spending on 12-minute quarters, that's an hour a game. You're gonna wanna make sure your percentages are wavy. For corner specialists especially, like, pretty much every, like, there's gonna be a lot of builds that's gonna have to get this badge. You're gonna wanna shoot over 50%. At first, my guy was shooting like 45, but as I started to get the method down, like literally every game, I was shooting 60%. By the time you finish all these badges, you will have hot spots all around the three-point line. You gotta put up a decent amount of shots for all of these, so all around the arc. For limitless range, you'll get the two on the wing, and the top of the three-point line, corner specialist and deep range deadeye will help you get the ones in the corner, and literally you'll get catch and shoot by accident. It takes a while to get these badges, right? Now, especially, the most of them are pretty simple. It's not a difficult concept to understand. It's just repetitive, it's a grind. I was up for like 4 straight nights playing 12 hours a piece trying to get these badges. I literally don't understand how, for the people that don't have to deal with Hall of Fame badges, you don't know how lucky you have. Now, I'm lucky now because I have Hall of Fame badges, but the grind to get to Hall of Fame is 162,000 points. That makes the grind to gold feel like next to nothing. All right, a few other strategies that might be able to help y'all. Pick and pops are important. Closer to the start, I was doing a lot of this, but I realized that my bum-ass teammates wouldn't find me open, so I was like, how do you do this? And that's when Snubby helped me out with limitless range. But you're gonna wanna try pick and pops if this stuff isn't working for you. Try sneaking up from the backcourt. Let your team get on offense and stay in your backcourt, and then just lurk, and then swing in there and try and pull up for limitless range. Yo, you know the pro AI play like Hall of Fame AI this year, all right? So you're gonna try and find ways to juke them. If you're before the half court line, they're chilling. They're not playing defense, they're just relaxing. And so the second you pass the half court line, they're like, ooh, like their alert goes off in their brain and they start to run after you. And so you literally have like a clock starts to run down once you pass the half court line. It's a thing, it's worth trying, but for me, I didn't see too much success off of it, especially because I was playing with the Mavs and they were doing an awful job of spacing the floor, so it just made life challenging for me. If this helps, go for difficult shots first. Play some park, play some pro-am. Difficult shots is one of the badges you can get by just playing online. Because when you're getting deep range deadeye, the badge doesn't even pop up. See, some of y'all wonder, Asia, why is my deep range deadeye badge not popping up? Am I not doing it right? Literally, the times where you're getting deep range deadeye, difficult shots will pop up. When you're going for those heavily contested shots, difficult shots will pop up. That badge is incredibly important. Pure sharpshooters have it on silver. So if your build can get difficult shots, it will make your life easier on getting those deep range deadeye and corner specialist badges. And last but not least, for those of you wondering which jump shot I used on my career, I made a video on it. I literally used my pro-am jump shot. I had a bunch of jump shots I tried. I even DM people asking, yo, what jump shot are you using? Because I was seeing people get big gains. But then I switched to my pro-am jump shot, and then I started to light things up, and I never looked back. I'll leave a card up above and a link in the description if you guys want to go through my jump shot video. I had a park and a pro-am jump shot I was talking about. Hey man, shout out to y'all too, because I'm seeing a bunch of tweets, people DMing me, Skyping me, texting me. Yo, Agent, I've been killing it with your pro-am jump shot. I'm like, word, aye, okay. Okay, man, yo. Hey, it's nothing, man. No problem, yo. Hey, if y'all enjoy, make sure to subscribe. Drop a like. Do all that good stuff. Hey, show some love. It took me too long to get these badges. I tried out every which way, every specific strategy. So if this helped, there you go. Catch y'all later. I'm out. Peace.